Here's the final product. I hated that there's a god tier, but if I had to pick a number one, you know, it'd be Osnafu, Origaru. Reason why is this the main character. This is like one of my favorite main characters, and that single-handedly just carried the show. And although the supporting characters was interesting, it's all funny, silly in the first season, but then it gets serious in the second season and third season. I think you'll like the show a lot. It's just typical a high school romance anime, but the main character is awesome. Second, top tier, and now going with the first one, Your Name. If you haven't watched this or heard of this, I don't know what to say. Next, Kaguya-sama Love is War. This is like the modern romance anime right now. Like, I don't know what romance anime is popping right now. Maybe Rent-A-Girlfriend when it comes out, but besides that, that's coming out later. Kaguya-sama Love is War, the first season, second season, they were all good. And then this third season that's coming out in the spring of 2022, there's a short trailer that came for it, and I love the trailer. It's basically making fun of anime fans. It's relatable, psychological. Watch it. I think most of you have, I assume. Now, this one, Welcome to NHK. I feel like a lot of you did not watch this or haven't heard of this. Well, that's because this released in 2006 or somewhere around that. But along with Kaguya-sama and Origaru, Welcome to NHK is relatable. I feel like I could relate to a lot. And just like Origaru, the main character is also a loner. I wouldn't say he's more interesting than Origaru, but still, the story is good. You just see his day-to-day struggles as a college dropout. Yeah, you just see how he overcomes that. And also, knowing that it came in 2004, 2006, it's a different vibe, along with amazing openings. For you guys that barely watch any old-school animes, watch this one. Hey, old-school animes are becoming masterpieces. I mean, look at Neon Genesis. High tier, Real Life, another whole high school romance anime. The reason why it's on high tier is because these couples are interesting and like they're opposite from each other, but still how they, you know, develop feelings for each other, it's pretty cool. And same with the story. These guys go back in high school. You know the movie 17 again? It's just like that. Now, upper mid tier. Into the Forest of Fireflies. I think that's what it's called. It's a 45-minute movie. That's all I'm going to say. I guess here, I'll say some more things. Like, in the beginning, you already know what's going to happen at the ending. But right when the ending comes the feels. Now, onto the next one. Has the Moon So Beautiful? This is another high school stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of high school stuff I got here. What made me like it is animation. It's pretty beautiful. The couple is kind of, they're both shy. I was curious to see how they got together. I was pretty bored in the beginning, but, you know, it was realistic, slice of life. It was pretty cool. Now, I feel ashamed that this is even in the mid-tier. Domestic Girlfriend, even though the story is not good, it's still kind of entertaining knowing that the main character has feelings for his stepsister. Or should I say stepsisters? They have a fire opening too. Yeah, it's up to you. Twin Star Exorcist. Now, I watched this a while back. I forgot a good amount of this. So that's why it's mid-tier, because, you know, it wasn't that memorable to me, but I still remember some parts. I do remember the feeling, though, and the ending was satisfying. The show wasn't that bad. This had a great amount of action, and they did well with the romance stuff. Yeah, they did pretty good mixing it together. Next, School Days. Reason why I wanted to see it is because I heard it was messed up. Psychological story, I would say, is not that good. I did not like this main character, but still, the psychological intense stuff is what kept me going. Yeah, it wasn't that bad. Next one, Garden of Words. I think this was also kind of short. It's a teacher and a student bonding, and the student had feelings for the teacher. Along with that, animation was really beautiful. It kind of gave me a Your Name vibe. I tried watching this and I got bored of it. A couple months later, I decided to watch again, and it wasn't that bad. Lower mid tier. I forgot the title, but here you go. Main character was quiet but strong. Basically, he goes into a school and just meets all these types of girls in the boarding school. Each of these girls have their own interesting story, and that's about it. And you just see how he solves their problem, develops a relationship with them one by one. The story was pretty average, but not bad. I know there are more. I only watched this season because I think this was good enough for me to know. Myself, Yourself. This is pretty old. Characters, I guess, was not bad, but it would still be in the mid-tier. Tamako Love Story. This love story, it was a cute story. I wouldn't say it's really that good. There's a series before this I tried out. It was really bad. I watched this movie first. You're supposed to watch the series first. That's how it is supposed to be. But I did not watch the series, and I did not like it. So just me watching the movie first. If you watch the movie first, that's perfectly fine. You're not missing out much, in my opinion. But it was cute. That's all I gotta say. Lower mid-tier. Snow White with the Red Hair. The story and the romance of this was not bad. It was cute. Reason why I wanted to watch this is because I like the old school medieval stuff. That's about it. That's all I can say. Toradora. In the beginning, it was all comedy, and I wasn't a fan of that. I was almost about to drop this, but something told me to keep going because this is like one of the classics. Towards the ending, that's when things got serious and I actually enjoyed it a lot. I guess like watching through all that boring stuff made it worth it, but still it wasn't great enough for me to consider, you know, a great anime. Now this, I'm gonna disappoint a lot. Bunny Rascal Senpai. When this released, there was a lot of hype on this and I was watching it. I wasn't really into it. When things got serious, that's what interested me. There's a good amount of episodes where I just skip forward to it. I guess it didn't appeal to me. Bottom tier, Love and Lies. This was pretty bad. I mean, there was a couple of soundtracks that I liked, but the story was pretty bad. Yeah, that's all I gotta say. And the shit tier. This had the potential. Like, I like the story of this. I was reading the summary of a main character trying to get revenge on a girl that used to pick on this main character because he was fat. But now he got into shape. Now he's, you know, good looking. And he wanted to get revenge on this girl. But it was poorly done. And I stopped halfway through it. I skipped to the ending to see how the ending was going to be like. Did they get together? Did not like it. And there's also another list of this tier list. And this is like the ones I haven't seen. And look at all this. They even had Boku no Pico on this. I don't know why they had this. That's not even a romance anime. These are all the stuff that I did not watch. If there are some shows that you know that are worth watching, let me know. This is a shit ton that I did not watch. All right, thanks for watching. Happy anime.